I really enjoy using old tools that belong to our family. This is an old sledgehammer I got from my grandpa's toolbox. I started cleaning the rust off of the tool using the angle grinder. I sanded with 80 grit. You can dip the iron into vinegar for a couple of days if you want an even better result. To get to the difficult areas, I used a wire brush bit on my drill. At this point, I was happy. I wanted to keep the imperfections from the years of abuse. After all, they are its history. Here, I kind of transfer the old handle's proportions on a piece of oak. Using my circular saw, I rough cut the blank. I roughly squared my stock on the bandsaw and the mitre box. Next, I designed the handle's shape. Here, I cut the first side on the bandsaw. I then used the offcut as a guide to draw the other side. And I cut the other side on the bandsaw. Off camera, I resharpened the bandsaw's blade. It was a pretty hard wood. I used a few drops of hot glue to re-glue the offcuts on the piece. I then drew the other side view of the handle. And back to the bandsaw again. The offcut became again the guide for the other side. The handle was roughly shaped at this point. Here I mark the handle's tenon. Based on that, I created roundover guidelines. I began shaping with a spoke shave. If you don't have a spoke shave, you can use a rasp. Next, you clean the rasp's marks with a file. And finish with 100 grit sandpaper. I actually like to use all the tools I got depending on the situation. In this end grain area, I use the tool diagonally to kind of cheat on those hard end grain fibers. Every now and then, I re-establish my guidelines. The whole shaping process is actually blending those lines to create the curves you want. Here I began shaping the tenon slowly. I then hammered the handle in place to get a mark from the iron. You can see the mark at the bottom. Then I slowly work on the tenon until the mark is removed. This was a slow process with a lot of back and forth. But I did it because the mortise inside of the hammerhead is conical. I repeated those steps until the handle gradually went through the hammerhead. Next, I finished shaping the rest of the handle. I started sanding with 100 grit. Then I moved at 220. I stopped at 320 grit. I think that was more than enough for that kind of tool. Here I mark the slot position for the wedge. To cut the slot, I used a handsaw. To make sure I cut straight, I first cut from one side and continued from the other. I repeated these steps several times. Next, I used a piece of walnut to make a wedge. I cut it on the bandsaw and shaped it on the belt sander. I then placed the wedge in the slot and hammered the handle all the way in. Next, I added glue on the wedge and hammered it in place. Here I cut the excess on the bandsaw. And I sanded it flush with the grinder. I finished the handle with the beeswax and mineral oil finish I made in a previous video. I added the paste on the metal as well, so I can protect it from rust. And that's the final piece. Now, let's give it a try. So that was it, guys. See you soon with a new project video.